Joseph.
Yeah, Dr. Kerry is here. We are coming straight to the lodge.
Hello.
Today we have an injured rhino. I presume, I think it was injured by a buffalo. And we have the vet here. We're going to dart the rhino. And then the vet's going to attend to its wounds.
So the doctor will first look at it and then he will dart it. And from there he will most probably clean the wound out and give it an antibiotic shot just to help with the infection and so on. And then he would give a most probably an ointment of some sort directly onto the wound that will also help with the healing process.
He should stand for quite a long time before he goes and lies down, and hopefully he won't go into the bush or he won't fall into a hole and stuff like that. That's all stuff that can go wrong. And then once he's down and once it's safe for us to work with him, I'll pull you guys in and you can come up and look around him. I'll be completely focused on treating the wound and getting that right. So the wound, I saw a photograph of it. If it was on a reserve that wasn't as well managed as far as anti-poaching and stuff like that was concerned, I'd be really concerned that it's a bullet wound. It looks like a bullet wound, and some of the poachers don't really shoot all that well, so if they aim for the chest they hit them at the back. But I'm hoping that it's a natural wound, so either from a fight with another bull. Okay, the dart's in. It was a nice shot on the shoulder, and we normally give them about 6 to 8 minutes to see if there's any sign of them showing effect from the drug. There's quite a few things that can happen although the dart hits and it sticks, where the drug doesn't get injected. So it's important just to watch and make sure that they are showing signs and effect. If they're not showing anything by about 8 to 10 minutes, then we'll put a second dart in. This is it's a medication to stop the maggots and to keep it free of maggots. It works for about a month. His breathing is really nice and stable and regular and deep. And his ears are moving, which is really good. Okay, so we've given him the wake up, now the reversal. The wound was probably from a fight, they think, with a buffalo. It's quite a sharp cut, but it's only in the skin. It hasn't gone through into the muscles and it hasn't penetrated into the abdomen, so he should heal up quite nicely. You'll see his breathing, legs stop shaking, his breathing starts becoming a lot deeper. Start rolling onto his chest.
Hello, my boy.
He'll start calling his friend now, and then he should come in as well. Oh, Rhino are a special animal. They're the epitome of conservation success in South Africa. They started off very, very low, and we got up to a population of about 20,000. Unfortunately, the poaching is now a big problem. But on a personal, intimate level with a rhino, they're just the most awesome animals. They've got extremely strong bonds with each other. You saw on that one today, that cow didn't want to leave that bull at all. We had to keep her away while we were working with him. And the first thing that he did when he got up onto his chest, even before he stood up, is he started calling for her. and you could see immediately she answered, and she came and she stood, despite us being 15, 20 meters away from that bull, she came and stood 2-3 meters away from him, waited for him to get up. And I think if you look at the footage, I think he was just having a really, really good sleep, because normally they, when you reverse them, they roll onto their chests and they stand up and then they walk off, and he was just sleeping, and until a minute or two later I clapped my hands and then they got up and they left. But that connection between individual animals and it's almost heart-wrenching and tear-jerking if you work, especially with a cow and a calf, and you see that bond between the cow and the calf. And when we work with cows and calves, for whatever reason, if we've got to treat one of them, you very often have to immobilize both of them, because the one won't let you get to the other one when it's immobilized. So no, the rhino is special work.